In this video, we're going to look at creating a charge payoff for the credit card. In the previous two videos, you saw that on cash management, we created credit card transactions and credit card fees. By the way, credit card transactions can be imported. You do not have to enter them in manually. You can pull down a template from the company module and import those transactions yourself. Charges cannot be imported, the credit card charges and fees. Now for charge payoff, you want to click the little plus sign. Now charge payoffs, normally most people think of that as paying off the credit card. Actually, what the charge payoff does in cash management is prepare to pay off the charges in AP. Charge payoff collects all the transactions that you want to pay off, and it'll push it over to AP as an AP bill. So let's come over here. And just in case I missed showing you, went to cash management, all charge payoffs, I hit the little plus sign. We'll choose our credit card number. You can put in a reference number, attachment, an attachment, put in a description if you want to. Apply filters. And you can put in a date range if you have a lot, but I know we only have a few, so I was no point in putting it in, but you can put in that date range. You'll click the charges you wish to pay off. Notice you can change the amount that you're paying. You don't have to pay the full amount, but we're conscientious types. And you can put the dimensions on here too. It's not too late if you need to. We're conscientious types, so we're going to pay off our credit card in full. We don't like the debt. If you see a button here where it says post and new, don't worry about it. You can just click the down arrow and just do a post. At this point, you click post. And it'll be pushed over. Now we'll go to AP. So let's go to AP. Click on AP. Click on bills. And there it is. There's our bill from cash management. As you can see in AP, it can be edited. It cannot be edited. You could print it if you needed to. So send the bills. And click view if you want to. And look at posting details. Here's our posting details. Credit to AP. Debit to our credit card liability, which clears out the credit card liability. We come over here to pay bills. And don't worry, I'm going through this fast, but we'll go through this again in accounts payable. We're going to pay by check from our Wells Fargo bank. And let me see, I need to clear my filters. And there's my charge payoff. The thing about pay bills is you have to clear the filter in order for your bills to show up. I don't know why they do that. They just do. It has been from the very beginning. But in here, you choose your payment method. You can choose check. You're not going to pay by credit card on a credit card. I guess you could, but I don't think it's going to work that way. Record transfer, which would be like an EFT draft. So if your charge payoff, so if your credit card is paid off each period, in full, that would be a record transfer or draft, or you could do it through ACH or cash. We're going to do it by check because it's easy for my demo. Currency, payment methods we'll get into later in AP about whether the vendor would want one check for all their bills or multiple, but we only have one bill, so it doesn't matter. You choose your bank. It tells you the amount of available funds in the bank here. Don't worry if you're funds are too low, it will still let you process the payment in Intacct. You'll just need to have it positive by the time you actually make the payment. We'll explain that more in AP. We'll click the bill that we want to pay. You can see if there's any credits available and to apply the credits, the amount you want to pay. You don't have to pay the full amount. Now, this is something interesting because suppose you've gotten a huge refund on your credit card back. You can create a negative charge payoff, and it would be processed through AP. What would happen is you'd process it, pay it, and it would create a credit on your credit card vendor in AP for use at a later time to pay off more charges. So we have it here. We have everything that we want. We'll click Pay Now. One payment request has been successfully posted. You can come here, go to posted payments, and you know what we're going to see? Nothing. Oh no, what happened? Well, that's because we paid by check. When you pay by check, you have to come down here and you have to actually print the check out in order for anything to happen. So let's choose our bank account. Whoops. Here's one thing, and I'll tell it to you again when we go into AP. Your check style by default is blank, which drives people crazy, namely me. So if you don't see your bank and you don't see a check, you need to make sure you're on the right check style. So printed checks comes up here. I have to choose my checking account. I chose Wells Fargo because that's what I paid for. If you choose the wrong bank, it's just going to show you zip. There'll be nothing there. You choose the right bank and you choose print. You can't confirm it until you print it. That's because if the check comes out all messed up, you have to reprint it. If you've already confirmed it, you have to go through the whole void process and it's not fun. So we'll come here, we'll print. Oh, now you see, remember when we were creating the banks, I told you that you had to have a routing number in there? I don't have a routing number in there, so it gave me a big old error. I'll fix that at a later date. For now, just know this is how you do the charge payoff. You print the check. You know what? We can do this. What I did is I went to AP View Payment Request. In the View Payment Request screen, you can cancel the request, something like this. And what that does is it takes you back to pay bills and makes the bill available for payment again. So let's do it this way. And this time, let's do ACH. Works out good because I need something there anyway for our AP module. Let's choose our bank. And of course, we don't have anything set up. Well, I'm just hitting on all fours today, ain't I? So hold on. Okay, well, I've had multiple issues. So we're going to do it as a record transfer. They're going to draft it for us. For some reason, my ACH setup does not work the way it should. So we're going to do it this way. We're going to do a record transfer, which is an EFT. That means it's electronic funds transfer outside of Intacct, normally set up by draft, as I said. We're going to do it full bore here. Like I said, if it was a negative value, it would create a credit on the vendor. We'll click here and click pay now. You can put a memo in here if you want to. Click save. Once payment request successfully made, we can go to view payment request here. See, there's nothing here. We can come up here to posted payments and see that it's been paid. Yahoo! Then we can go back to cash management, look at the registers, credit card, all cards because we only have one, click view. And there we go. We have our charges, we have our payments, and we have a zero balance. Yahoo! So that ends our credit card transactions videos.